What's up, guys? This is your friendly bartender, Alan. And today we're going to talk about injuries, particularly on the elbows and on the shoulders. So before we begin, I want to clarify that I'm not a physical therapist. This is purely from my experience, and I'm just sharing this information to help you. And now that that's out of the way, let's get to it. So why am I talking about shoulder pain and elbow pain on the same episode? The reason is because it's most likely caused by the same thing, which is going to be an internally rotated shoulder. So what is internal rotation? Internal rotation is basically the downward rotation of the shoulders this way, almost like pouring a pitcher of water. And the opposite direction is going to be called external rotation, which is basically like a hitchhiker movement this way. So why are these two movements important? Well, if you're a bartender, you're going to do a lot of internal rotation. When you're pouring liquor into the out of the bottle, you're essentially doing internal rotation here, which is going to overdevelop the anterior delt and the upper pec. External rotation is also important because that's basically how most people are going to do the one-handed shake. You have a shaker here, and you're going to pull it back up like this and shake. So having weak external rotator cuff muscles also can cause pain due to lack of shoulder stability, especially when shaking that heavy cold draft ice. So why is internal rotation bad? And before we can get started with that, we got to understand how the shoulders work. So our shoulders are not like a ball and socket joint. If you look at it closely, it's actually just floating pieces of bone that's held up by muscles. And depending on how they are arranged, it can actually limit your movement. Let's give this a try. With the internally rotated shoulder this way, try to lift your arm straight up like this. There's going to be a point where it cannot go any higher, right? This is not, and if you try to force it, you might feel pain, but this is as far as I can go, right? Now, before we start, let's do an external rotation with our shoulders first, this way, and then we go up. Look at that, straight down, right? I didn't magically increase my flexibility. I just positioned my shoulder in a more advantageous point to do what I want. So if you're not engaging your external rotator cuff, you can hurt yourself. One common injury is when you reach for a bottle that's way too high, you're probably not engaging external rotation when you're doing so. And that's why some people, when they reach for something, they're gonna feel sharp pain. Another issue with internal rotation is what we talked about earlier, is the overdevelopment of the muscles that are involved in internal rotation. And you probably went to the gym and you've probably seen guys that are, you know, like, who are always doing the bench press every day and their shoulders are locked in like this. I mean, they think they look good because that's what they see in the mirror, but on a side profile, you can see all the shoulders getting rolled forward, and it's not a good look. And if you're gonna have to pour bottles regularly with one hand, it's going to be even worse because you're going to have an overdevelopment of one arm like this, and the other arm is going to be like this. It's also going to cause a lot of posture issues because you're not symmetrical anymore. And it's not only that, it's also on the forearms as well, because if you look at it this way, this arm's internally rotated and this arm's normal. And this is not visually pleasing, so what people will do, they'll rotate, supinate their wrists this way so it looks like it's normal on the hand portion. But if you look at the shoulders, it does not look even. And this can cause strain on the forearms as well. This is how it can cause elbow injuries. So prolonged internal rotation will cause stretching, can cause stretching. And prolonged stretching can also create weakness. You ever done yoga and you sat on a pose that's supposed to be for 30 seconds long, but there's a commercial or something came on and then you sat in that pose a lot longer and you got out of that pose, you probably felt a lot of pain, because you're not supposed to be stretched out for long periods of time. Okay, so how do we correct this? So I have a few exercises that might help because they help me a lot. And even though a lot of my shoulder pain has disappeared, I still do them just because as a preventative, because I also lift a lot of weights and I also bartend. And as long as I'm gonna, you know, pour a bottle with my right hand, it's gonna create imbalances that are always gonna have to be corrected. So it's a good way to prevent injuries as well, even though if you don't have it right now. One of them is going to be a shoulder dislocates. You can do these with a resistance band, which is preferable because the elasticity will help adjust your different mobility problems. But a broomstick or a towel will also work as well, but those will not accommodate to mobility issues. So if you have a resistance band, I highly recommend it, but a towel or a broomstick will work as well. The next exercise I like is called a wall angel. You probably are familiar with snow angels when people go on the floor and they start waving their arms around. These are going to be very similar but a little different. First, be sure to take off your watch. But the idea is to have the wrist and the elbows hold back against the wall while you're leaning against it. If you don't have the mobility to do so, you can lean your you can have your feet a little forward and bent on the knees. But the most important part is to have the wrists and the elbows touching the wall the whole time. And when I say wrists, I don't mean the knuckles. I've seen people drag the knuckles on this exercise, but they're just lying to themselves. You want to have the wrists always in contact against the wall. And the idea is that you want to have it moving up and down until there's slight discomfort. You're going to not only strengthen your external rotator cuff, but you're also going to fix your posture and increase your shoulder mobility as well. So last but not least are the face pulls. And the face pulls are actually one of my favorite exercises in general, and not just for physical therapy, but also for building strength. You could do them with a band, like what we were using earlier, but you can also do them against the wall if you like. And one thing to focus on is not just to pull to your face. You want to focus on the wrists again, just like the wall angels. And you want to imagine pulling your wrist behind your ear. That's the motion. Because remember, external rotation is like a hitchhiker thumb. You want that motion. And that's what you're trying to strengthen. And you want to also not only get stronger at it, but also increase the mobility in that direction as well. Well, anyways, I hope you guys found that video helpful. If you have any comments or any questions about other bartending related injuries, please write them down below. And if you haven't done so, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you next time.